Hi, I'm Tim Van Milligan. This is going to be an overview of a product called the Impulse Fiber Sport Bundle. And as you can see, it's a launch system that includes a pad with 5 rods, and you also get a 12-volt battery, a launch controller, and this down here on the ground is called the wired console. So I'll kind of go over what it does and why you might want it for your next launch system, particularly if you're a school or a club that's just getting started. First off, it's a complete system. So you get everything you see here, except for the rockets, of course. And what I like about it is that it gives you a really long cord. And you can't see it, but this cord is 50 feet long. And it's an Ethernet cord that connects the launch control box to the wired console down here, and you can remove the Ethernet cord and you can replace it with a longer one if you want. This has been tested up to a 500 foot Ethernet cord. So if you want to use it for launching high power rockets, this will work just fine. So the other nice thing about this is the battery comes with it, and this is a 12 volt car starter battery. So if your car breaks down, you could actually use this to start your car, to jump start your car. And it has a little connector on the end that will plug right into the wired console down here. Okay, so now this is plugged in. I'm going to disconnect it from the launch controller here on this end. So now this is completely isolated. So you can't launch from this right here, but you can check the continuity of your rocket. So what's continuity? Continuity is to make sure that you have a complete circuit. So here are 2 wires, and I got a little igniter right here. And if I wanted to check if this igniter was good, that's called checking the continuity. So normally this would be up inside the rocket, inside the rocket nozzle. But since I'm indoors, I have no rockets in here because I don't want to launch anything indoors. So here is the igniter, and it's hooked up to the clips. And if I wanted to check continuity, I can just come to this box right here, and you can see this is pad number 3. So I would just come down here to the number 3 button and just push it, and it will tell me that this is a good igniter. If I disconnect it and push it again, nothing happens. So this allows your students to load their rockets on the pad and check continuity by themselves. And you can see it's completely isolated from the launch control box, so they can't launch a rocket by themselves. So now let's show how the controller works. Okay, so now I'm going to plug it in. I'm going to connect the Ethernet cord. One end goes here, and it doesn't matter which end goes into which box. They're completely, it's just, you know, it doesn't matter. Okay, so now they're connected. And then from here, I can also check continuity. First, I need to put the key in. So it's got a safety key. Get it in there the right way. Turn that on, and this was pad 3. And I can just check it right here. And if I disconnect it again over here, I push down on it, and I can tell there's no continuity. Let me put this back on. So now when you're ready to launch, there's actually 4 safety interlocks in this system. The first one is here at the launch pad. So once your students hook up their rockets and hook up the igniters, the last person to leave the pad will switch this switch right here from safe to arm. So then they just push it up like that. And so now you still can't launch the rocket, but that's the first safety key right there. That's number 1. The second one is the safety key here on the box. That has to be turned on. The third one is you have to select the launch pad. And then the fourth one is you have to throw the safe switch here and move it from safe to arm. So now it's armed, and you can hear a different tone. That tone is coming from this box right here. And that tells us, you know, if somebody was out at the launch pad and they heard that siren sound, they would know to get away. So I can turn that off. by clicking on the safe button right here. So now when you're ready to launch, again, we'll turn that on, turn this to arm, and then we can push the launch button. 3, 2, 1, and then I want you to watch the igniter right here. 3, 2, 1, fire. You can see it just fires off instantly. The other nice feature about this pad is I can do up to 5 launches all at the same time. I can select all 5 pads or any combination of pads, and then I can launch them right here from this one box. So you can have a drag race with your rockets. So this is a very safe system. The other feature in this system is the launch pad itself. And as you can see, there's rods for 5 different rockets. These are all 1/8-inch rods, but it also includes 2 3/16-inch rods. And so those are for your bigger rocket motors that might take a D or an E engine. And those rods are actually stored, let me go over here on this side, inside the tube right here. So if I tilt this down, those rods should slide out. And so there's 2 additional launch rods in here for the bigger rockets. And all the rods just simply unscrew from the launch pad. And for storage, you just put them in here. The launch pad itself, once the legs fold up, stores in a bundle that's like this big and that long. And you can see it's really easy to store this system in your classroom. This is a very durable system. It's rated for, like I said, 5 rockets at one time. It's also, the pad is made out of metal and the control boxes are all plastic. So they are a little bit moisture resistant, not waterproof. You know, you wouldn't want them to go out in a downpour of a rain, but it can stand a light rain and then you just wipe it off and let it dry out and it'll work perfectly fine. So this is the Impulse Sport fiber pad system. It's a bundle. It contains 4 components: the launch pad, the wired controller, the battery, and the launch controller. And you can find it here at ApogeeRockets.com.